Welcome back to Dark Chronicle, and we're continuing into the Ocean War Cave. So this floor is for scary Auntie Medusa. But first off, let's go above ground and see what's happening up here. Well, here's the Auntie Medusa. So our burn subjective here is to only use the gun, and then kill everything. But the gun isn't really too effective against these guys, so we're not going to bother with that. Right, that's very good. That's exactly what we wanted, the magic crystal. Now we'll be able to easily see where the geostone is. And the map, that's very good. Thank you, game. You actually gave me the two things I wanted. Ah, these frogs. What is with their jumping? They somehow managed to avoid all my gunshots. Ah, this Shiva is actually a recolor of an enemy we haven't seen yet. It was supposed to be in Chapter 2, near one of the last dungeon floors, but since we went through those very quickly, we didn't actually get a chance to see her. Well, let's increase the map size. So we'll continue outside first, just in case the enemies need to kill her out here. Right, so we didn't get a chance to see this last time, because Monica sadly died for the first time on screen, which is pretty good. I want this guy to continue to cast spells at us. Nope, it looks like it's going to continue to try and charge us. So you may notice, to the left of our sword... Don't get away from us, I want to show this, you stupid game. There you go, and now we've got all four charges, we can throw out a frost attack. Since that water blast thing it does its frost elemental. And we basically just do an empowered version of our magic. So that's sort of like a magic counter-attack type absorb thing that our sword can do when it's a high enough level. We couldn't do it with a previous version of his sword, but since we upgraded it, we can now do that. So the key of using that is basically to absorb one element, and then use it against another enemy that's weak to it. So for example, if there's two elementals, like a fire and a frost one, then you absorb all of one of them before the other one, and it will do extra damage. Pretty straightforward. But of course you need them to actually cast at you and not just charge at you and try and slap you in the face. These guys can dodge gunfire but not swords. Either that or Max is just a really bad aim. It's going to take us a while to get down, we may as well get on the ride pod, speed up a little bit. There, that's much better. Yeah, getting at least the rollerblades. I only just mounted you, ride pod, shut up. Yeah, we're probably going to turn my voice box off soon. Empty chests. Go screw yourself, game. Why'd you get those? Well, that's a very good placement for the end. It's right next to the entrance. But first off,
leave it to me.
Okay, I'll leave it to you then. You just told me to get off you, and now you're saying to leave it to you.
Let me at
him. As I mentioned before, Ride Pod's attack is still very weak at the moment because this gun was actually one from Chapter 2. It was still good for Chapter 3, but now it's starting to age at this point. We'll end up getting another gun soon to replace it.
Get off your lazy behind!
We could actually go and make one now, but there's not really any point to do it.
Piece of cake!
Just because we're not going to be using the ride pods to actually attack things enough to validate really bothering to upgrade this gun we currently have until we actually get the next good one. There's the geostone and a chest nearby, may as well grab both. The thing I do like about using the guns is, as long as of I'm like avoiding actually picking up those level up things is that you can just basically kill stuff while still moving away from it.
Wait till they get a load of this!
Am I getting really unlucky with this key, or did it actually drop and I didn't notice it?
Piece of cake!
It's most likely the latter, isn't it? Oh no, there it is, Luna Stone, I just got it.
Leave it to me!
Well, may as well kill this fine enemy.
Leave it to me!
Okay, there are some mimics on this floor then, because all the enemies are dead, but there's still a couple of treasure chests. Well, our gun's broke, so we can no longer leave it to Steve, as he keeps wanting us to tell him to do. So let's just leave. I'm pretty sure that soon we're going to get to a point where we can start doing speedos to the fishing. Yep, speeder now. So that was a fishing one, but now we're coming to speeder, which means if it's no longer going to be an outside area in these dungeons anymore, it's only going to be inside areas. And then near the end of a dungeon we'll get back to fishing again, because we'll start getting on the other side of the cave. You may also notice the picture we just went to then, like, there's a blue, the image is blue instead of white to indicate that it's inside the cave. Ah, these statues are always going to be annoying. We need smash to kill them, so we can't use our gun on these ones. So as I mentioned in the last part, I'm not going to be picking up these experience orbs anymore so we can do the dungeons quicker. If you're actually playing this game yourself, I would definitely not recommend doing that. Because obviously you do need to get them to level up. I'm just going to do some off-screen grinding at the end of the chapter. So these sand molars are those great enemies I hated from the second chapter of the game. They're back now. Yeah, these guys are gonna continue to be annoying. Constantly breaking lock on and constantly running underneath us. Well, that statue just broke our guard. We're starting to become a little bit more powerful then. Well, we'll try and do some speed events, so we'll make sure to actually get the chest because of mimics. Oh great, exploding trap? Yeah. It's always good to guess those if you're gonna have to guess any. Just because the exploding traps, if they are exploding traps, all the loot inside will be destroyed as well when the chest explodes. Don't guard a laser beam, mate. We're having an easier time dealing with these guys now, though. I'm starting to get low health, so we're gonna just heal just to be safe at the moment. So in the last part, we did die because we neglected healing. Well, Monica died, rather. Because we got that double slap attack, which did probably like 10 damage each slap or something. We didn't bother to heal because we weren't at warning yet. So if we get below half health, I'm just going to heal for safety. We'll try to avoid that happening, and we do have Absorb as well, so we should be able to avoid it. Not quite a way to go until we reach the next one, so we may as well go on the ride pod. Let's also repair his weapon a bit. And get stuck in a rock. Brilliant.
Piece of cake.
I don't get it when our attack only does 3 damage for some random reason. Well, this guy's going to be annoying and we're not going to be able to damage him properly with the ride pod. Come on. guys are so annoying. I hate them. The opponent was just a no fun allowed type enemy. Always good. Oh, now he decides to come out of the ground. One time when I accidentally missed my attack, he then chose to come out. Yeah, these guys suck. So this room here is going to be problematic for Speeder, because there are actually holes in the ground here. It was a lot less of a work in the last chapter. Why are there so many of these moles? Why are there so many moles? This is stupid. Wow. Okay, that was very close. One HP, we just survived that. We don't actually have the key to leave now, but we'll try and do a game of Speeder while we're here. Oh, the exit's right there. It's very tempting to ignore it. Just used a healing item though, so we can't really take advantage of it. Never mind my stupid button presses mean we can't take advantage of it after all.
Alright, that takes care of you guys.
Okay. Got time attack cleared, and now we can replace with Speeder. Let's give it a shot. Only two, that's a little bit annoying. But it is just over there, the goal. So we should be able to clear this one. So let's equip our Speeder club and give it a shot. So if we hit that there, because you can rebound it off of walls like this. So ideally, we want to try and knock it somewhere where it would be useful. Oh, we could just try and hook it along, that's what I'm going to do. So if I control it like that... Oh, that's a very bad aim. Okay, so this is going to be very annoying to actually get inside, because it's the wrong colour at the moment, and this water is annoying, because it will basically mean that... Like, the water won't allow us to rebound as much off it. So the best we can really do is just try and get it to a point where it can hopefully knock on the ground. Nope, it didn't even knock hard enough to change colour. We're not going to bother with Speeder from here on out, not in this area. Because, yeah, the water basically means that it's not able to change colour. Which means that it's the wrong colour and can't go inside, because apparently that's exactly what you wanted to add to golf, to make it fun. It doesn't make it fun. So you would think that this area would be really easy to do Speeder in, because there aren't as many bottomless pits for it to land in. But no, because you can't actually change the colour properly. And if you can't rebound off a wall properly, you're kind of screwed. And here's the bat den. Or the preferred bat cave. I mean, it was right there, game. Right there, you could have easily picked bat cave. It was so close. Could have had some sort of Batman pun, but you didn't get it. Oh, there's the exit already, that's always good. Did that bat give us the Lunar Stone? Because if so, that's the best floor I've ever been to. No, it didn't. If only we can dream, right? more damage with our attack than we do with our gun here. Oh, there's the key. Now we just need to get the Geostone, which is right there. That's handy. Now we can leave. That's a good floor. I like that floor. Do you like that floor? I think that's a very good floor. Well-designed floor, with even a treasure chest there. I mean, you may as well grab it. I mean, it is here. Gonna give us an awesome thing. You know, wind elements, we need those. We do need those to be able to make Georama stuff. Well done, game. How about a good item from this as well? Let's throw this and see if we get something. Nope, we didn't get anything. You could have been perfect, game, but you weren't. But you were close to that. Best floor ever in this entire game. Let's go. And let's also, while we're on the map selection, make sure we did pick up a Geostone from the last area. I think I may have forgotten it. I haven't been paying much attention. No, I did get a Geostone. Yeah, I just wanted to make sure that I haven't been skipping Geostones. And there's the Pirate's Hideout. Let's go. Tanks here. And the map, that's always good. And the exit, once again, is right next to us. And there's the Geostone. We're quite good with this, aren't we? Let's give Monica some attention, eh? I do like her sword, after all. Yeah, her sword's a badass at this point. Well, it is a demon sword after all. What are you going to expect? You're going against a demon sword, guys. Does he use a bit of magic? Oh, giant treasure chest. Oh, let's just get away from that one. Let's kill him with gun. These King Mimics are still very, very deadly. If they go enraged like that because we have a very small anger gauge, then yeah, they can really destroy you quite easily. I wouldn't be too surprised if they actually did one-shot me, so I do want to be a little bit careful with them. Oh, we got the stone. Oh! Now, let's actually try and do... We're skipping Bowser Falls a little bit too quickly. We are about to get to a dead end, so we may as well do the an attempt at speed with this floor. It's a very small dungeon after all, so it's not going to take too long to do this. This pirate's not a very big hideout, it's got to be said. Just kick the pirate while he's down. I have my own dirty tactics, pirates. Just needed a pair of powder. Still got a good supply of it, but he just saves having to go back to town and buy more. He's got the ride pod to speed around a bit.
Piece of cake!
Might as well pick up those experience orbs on the way back. Tank versus tank, I like the idea of this.
Let me at him!
He just went at him. Come on, Steve, pay attention. Just ask me to let you at him. Don't complain at me and save your beat now.
Still, I'm beat, I tell you.
I just one more area we haven't been to yet. Let's go finish that off.
Leave it to me!
Oh, I didn't even realise I skipped all these enemies. Well, get back to max now. Just shoot the bar gun. Man, there are a lot of pirates here. I know it's about high down, but still, guys, there's a lot of you. Let's just back off. These guys are way too quick, didn't remember being this quick. You're just gonna keep backing up, tank. Okay. These guys don't seem to telegraph their attack too much, so I'm going to be a little bit careful about getting some melee range with them. Yeah, let's try poison, yeah. Poison trap sounds good to me. And there went all of our health again.
Alright, that takes care of you guys.
Well, we'll just have to deal with the beeping for the time being then, I guess. Yeah, let's go place feed it. See, it's got 5 uses on it and it's got to go over there. We should be able to do this one. Also, fine, let's just cure this so it's not annoying. No, I don't want to do that. I want to actually heal him. There we go. As long as the water doesn't screw us up too much, this one should be fine. We gotta pick the best route to go. We can either go upwards or we can go to the side. I think up is the best bet. Let's go that way. Just trying to hit too many walls and stuff. Should be fine. Oh, now the splash causes it to change colour, does it? That should go across. We'll just change it to that angle instead, just to be sure. That should be fine. Let's just knock it that way. Put a top spin on it so that it goes forwards when it lands. Oh, obviously it would hit the ceiling. Why would it not? That is a problem with these indoor areas, it's hitting ceilings. Right, let's go that way then. Pretty bad shot, but it worked. Ah, great, this is going to be annoying, isn't it? How the hell are we going to get it to change colour? Just need to knock it into it, using the map to hopefully help. That apparently goes through it, but we can't change the camera to be able to look. All I can see is the red lines that tell me that it goes into it. There we go. So apparently, the splashes we did last time, when it was a big splash from hitting it high up, didn't change colour, but the really small ones do. It's not exactly clear, is it? So what did we get? Chill stones. That's the most useless thing we can get. That's just damage. You know, just, oh look, it deals some ice damage. That's all it is. It's not special, it's not a gem to put onto our weapons or anything. It's not a coin. It's rubbish. Oh well. At least it's an extra medal, I guess. Anyway, let's head to the next area. hits his van. Let's quickly actually change weapon though first. The Cave of Ancient Murals. Well, let's go, this place sounds important.
What's all this?
It's one of those murals called Moon of Destruction. They discovered a whole bunch of them in my era, too.
Moon of Destruction.
They show an imaginary world where the moon comes crashing down, destroying mankind. Nobody's been able to figure out why there are so many of these things, or what purpose they served.
What's the point of so many murals, all exactly the same?
Maybe the ancient people were trying to tell us something with these murals.
Tell us something?
Oh, I don't know. It's just a hunch. Something about them makes me think so, I guess.
Hmm. Whoa!
Shingala? Controlled by it.
Look out!
He's not gonna listen to us! Shingala!
Run for it, pal!
So you may have remembered that mule from the very start of the game. As in, before we even started the game. That's what's in the background of the main menu.
What's happened to Shingala? He doesn't recognize me.
It's not that. You saw the strange device on his head? I'm sure that it's controlling him.
We've gotta think of some way to get it off of him.
Maybe the people at Luna Lab will know a way.
Yes, exactly! They might be able to help us. Let's go!
Yep, so it's actually time for us in the next episode to be dealing with more Giorama stuff, which is always fun. So, as for what just happened then, you may have listened to that quite cool music that came with Shingala. We'll be hearing more of that soon enough. But for the time being, we have to go and fix up this place, and it's night time, so that makes it a little bit, I suppose more fitting, since it's about Luna Lunar Lab and the like. But yeah, that ancient mural we saw was in the background of the main menu when we started the game. So that's actually a very important thing, and you've already probably pieced together why it's a very important thing, and why it exists. But if you haven't, then we'll probably find out more about that later. So for the time being, we'll record a video here, and in the next part we'll put in all of our geostones we just picked up, and we'll start to work restoring this place, putting a huge pier down here, and then moving on to actually recreate the Lunar Lab, and then go to the future and see what's happening at the Lunatic Wisdom Laboratory. So until then, be lovely to each other.